This is one of my sketchy setups. I didn't want to clamp this end cap into the vise because it's hollow and it's thin walled. I'm afraid that I might crush it or distort it. It is already, because of internal stresses and being clamped in a chuck on a lathe, gone oval by about 0.03 millimeters, and I don't want to distort it any further. So what I've done is I've used a threaded pin like this in between my two 1-3 blocks, and then this is clamping down into the blocks, and the blocks have been clamped down to the table. Now I've already found center, so I'm going to use my PCD function on the DRO to a 5-bolt hole pattern. And this is a venturis I've made last week or earlier this week, and encapsulated foot over it. I'll drill and tap a fixtures hole here on the side so they can clamp it into position. And then once we get the groceries for a gas injection for a nozzle, then I'll machine this part because I haven't got the sizes yet. So yeah, it's a very simple design. This is what it looks like when it's completed. Got a venturi on the one side. Now this comes from my smelting furnace. I've made this almost 2 years ago, and as you can see, the aluminium doesn't melt. It stays intact even though the burn tube corrodes because of the heat. Now, the important part of the burner is the baffle. If you don't have a baffle to create a low pressure zone on the end of the burn tube, your gas won't ignite. Now, some designs of forges uses the forge itself to create a baffle, but I prefer to make my baffles as part of the burner. So yeah, I hope you enjoy it. Until next time, God bless.